Maybe many of you don't know much about ships and the facts behind the production. One of them is the cost to build a ship. Supertanker, cruise, submarine, yacht, and aircraft spend a lot of money in the manufacturing process. You want to know how much it costs? So, here's a list of the 10 most expensive ships ever built in history from each class. Since 1877, the modern oil tanker was developed. The demand for oil around the world makes the existence of tankers indispensable. The tanker turns into a supertanker. Although it looks simple, the tanker is a transportation that requires a lot of money in its manufacture. Liberty Bay. This ship is claimed as the most expensive tanker ever built in the United States. How much? $184.7 million. Liberty Bay is 820 feet long and has the capacity to carry 800,000 barrels of oil. This ship has many components, including main engine components and controls as well as fuel, lube oil, and electrical system to deliver energy efficiencies and better performance. It also features design enhancements for improved environmental protection. What do you imagine when you hear the word container ship? Big, slow, cheap, and old-fashioned? If that's what you have in mind, then you are not talking about this one container ship, who considered as the most expensive container ship ever built. Triple E class is derived from the class's three design principles: economy of scale, energy efficiency, and environmental impact improvement. The Triple E class container ships were built by South Korea's Daewoo Shipbuilding and Marine Engineering in 2011. This ship is also considered as the largest container ship in the world, with a length of 400 meters and can travel at a maximum speed of 23 knots. With all the complete capacities, it's no wonder the cost of this ship production is approximately $190 million. Not bad for a container ship, right? Don't be surprised if the cost of this research vessel production is very expensive, with $300 to $500 million. And making it as one of the most expensive research vessels ever built. As you can see, this ship shows a luxurious and modern look, even though this ship is used for research and expeditions. Rev Ocean was built in Romania and launched in August 2019. At 182.9 meters in length, 22 meters beam, and 5.25 meters draft, this research vessel is not like other research vessels. This is a hybrid vessel combining a yacht interior with an ice class hull and the laboratories of a polar research vessel. This research vessel even has a remotely operated vehicle that can descend to a depth of 19,000 feet. In research mode, the boat can accommodate 54 scientists plus 36 crews, many of whom are specialized technicians. As a charter, the yacht hosts 28 guests in 14 staterooms, along with 54 crews. Rev Ocean has 3 swimming pools, multiple common areas, several dining rooms, observation platforms, and thanks to the research site, a 35-seat auditorium, classrooms, and an onboard medical facility. Amazing! As we can see, this sailing yacht is not like other yachts. Not only because of its gigantic shape for the size of a sailing yacht, but also because of this attractive design. This yacht will make us feel at home just by looking at it. Sailing Yacht A, which holds the record as the most expensive sailing yacht in the world, is owned by one of the Russian oligarch billionaire, Andrei Melnichenko. Measuring almost 143 meters and a gross tonnage of about 12,600, sailing Yacht A become one of the most impressive super yachts in the world in terms of design and technology. The luxury sailing yacht's three masts are the tallest and most highly loaded freestanding composite structures in the world. With all these luxury components, no wonder these yachts can cost $400 million. Arktika is one of the biggest and most expensive nuclear icebreakers ever built, designed and constructed in Russia. Designed to operate efficiently both in shallow Arctic River estuaries as well as along the northern sea route, this icebreaker ship costs $500 to $720 million. Arktika is specifically designed to be capable of breaking 2.8 meters thick level ice at a continuous speed of 1.5 to 2 knots, or around 2.8 to 3.7 kilometers per hour at full power when operating in deep water at design draft. It even has really amazing facilities that you've never imagined before. One dining room, sauna, library, auditorium, passenger lounge, volleyball court, gymnasium, one swimming pool, infirmary, one elevator, one helipad with a Mi-2 transport helicopter. Did you know? Since the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, some of Russia's nuclear-powered fleet have run a profitable side job ferrying wealthy tourists to the top of the Earth, North Pole. Tickets for the unusual cruise start at around $30,995 per person. Are you interested? Allure of the Seas is one of the two most expensive cruise ships in operation around the world. Reportedly, around $1.4 billion was incurred in the construction of this world-class cruise ship at the STX Europe Turku shipyard in Finland. Allure of the Seas is also among the largest passenger ships ever constructed, stretching just 2 inches longer than its sister ship Oasis of the Seas. With a length of up to 362 meters and a width of 60.5 meters, this world-class cruise ship can accommodate a total of 6,780 guests and 2,200 crew members. Allure of the Seas delivers exhilarating onboard experiences than any other experience on land or sea to everyone who comes aboard. With 18 amazing decks hosting world-class entertainment, state-of-the-art technology, the fastest internet available at sea, conference facilities and meeting spaces that can host up to 1,500 guests, and a plethora of onboard activities to choose from. With all these amazing features, no wonder if this cruise ship costs $1.4 billion. If we can give one word to describe this super yacht, it will be stunning. The History Supreme, owned by Robert Nock, is the world's most expensive, largest super yacht in the whole world. How much did it cost? $4.6 billion. Don't be surprised. Why? Because it took 3 years to build, using 10,000 kilograms of solid gold and platinum, both of which adorn the dining area, deck, rails, staircases, and anchor. What else does this ship have? The master suite features a meteorite rock wall, a statue made of Tyrannosaurus Rex bones, and a 68-kilogram, 24-karat gold Aqua Vista panoramic wall aquarium. Being in the right hands, the History Supreme yacht is undeniably great. So, this is the number one biggest and baddest, most expensive submarine that is used by the Navy today. The Terrible is a French mega submarine that cost 3.1 billion euros to build. Yeah, that's right, billion with a B. In other words, convert that to American dollars and it's more like $4 billion. Not to mention, that was around 15 years ago, when it was built in 2000. So add on inflation and it's even more like $5 billion. It's not quite as fast as some of the others, but it packs a hell of a punch, because it is after all classified as a nuclear ballistic missile submarine. The Terrible can fit a total of 111 people, and it does so comfortably, and it is also equipped with some of the highest tech sonar, stealth systems, and anything else you could think of. The Terrible isn't actually that terrible as the name would make you think, and for that price, it really shouldn't be. It has a huge armament capability, 16 nuclear missiles, 4 torpedo tubes, and anti-ship missiles, all of which can be fired when submerged. This bad boy can go fast too, with a 200,000 horsepower nuclear pressurized water reactor that on its own can last for 25 years without stopping, a water jet propulsion system, and 2 diesel engines that give off more than 40,000 horsepower themselves. All of this means it can reach speeds close to 50 kilometers per hour. And remember, that's underwater. All the while, weighing over 14,000 tons. As we can see, this ship has a really complex construction. Not surprisingly, the cost production of this large ship is really expensive, estimated at around 12 to 17 billion US dollars, and making it as the second most expensive ship ever built, after the USS Gerald R. Ford. This ship, which was launched in South Korea in 2013, also has been named as the number one largest ship still active in service today. If compared, this ship's length is even longer than the very famous skyscraper in New York, United States, the Empire State Building. This giant ship has a length of up to 488 meters, with its height of up to 105 meters, and is made with more than 260,000 tons of steel. Another unique fact about this giant ship is, its oil storage capacity is equivalent to 175 swimming pools for the Olympics. Well, these facts clearly show us why Prelude FLNG is considered as the largest, longest, and also one of the most expensive ships ever built, which is still in service. What an extraordinary ship, right? The United States is titled as a superpower country. One of the reasons is because of its army, proved by an aircraft carrier and warship named USS Gerald R. Ford, or CVN-78. The USS Gerald R. Ford has a new type of nuclear that can generate 3 times more electricity than compared to the preceding vessel classes. It also has a new type of electromagnetic catapult, or known as electromagnetic aircraft launch system, replacing its traditional system catapults. With this technology, Gerald R. Ford can accomplish 25 more aircraft launches per day than the Nimitz class, and requires 25% fewer crew members. The warship, which can carry more than 75 aircrafts and service life of up to 50 years, also was developed to incorporate many technological advancements to ensure that it will be the most capable and efficient carrier in service anywhere in the world. By March 2018, due to issues with the nuclear propulsion system and munition elevators, construction costs had reached 13,027 billion US dollars, making Gerald R. Ford the most expensive warship ever built in history. Well, that's it. Be sure to subscribe and hit that like button. Thanks, and see you in the next video.